Texas. The roof is open, and we've got football from NRG Stadium in Houston. The scene from a few moments ago, this crowd enthusiastically cheering on their Texans as they emerge from the line. And we're just about ready for football as the Texans get set to match up with the Los Angeles Rams. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. Well, this defense for the Rams, they were terrific a week ago in that win over Detroit.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Watson, he's letting it fly for Cooks. And that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown, Houston. I think it's fair to say there's nothing that gets a crowd to its feet quite like a big play, and that was something special there. Boy, was he moving. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. Take a shot right away. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A big connection on that one. 38 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10.
Right here.
Throwing is Perkins. That's into the hands of Jacob Harris. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets
Let's
to
go,
the 10.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Our game not even 2 minutes old, but a quick red zone opportunity. It's first and 10 from the 12. Pickup of about four down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun, and they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
To throw is Perkins. Eluding the pressure right.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
Back to throw. Perkins toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Another shot from the one on second and goal.
59, Mike. 59, Mike. Check, check.
Akers, and he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. His fifth rushing touchdown on the year, number 7 overall. And the Rams are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Matt Gay on for the point. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive.
Better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Here's second and seven now from the 28.
I'm coming after you, four! Watch the twist. Alert flare. Alert. Line him up.
Now a handoff here to the running back. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
A quick pass there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Watson to throw on third and one. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Hawkins. And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40.
Yo. Begin. Boys down, he's coming. Put it down.
Now we'll play fake, and it's Watson. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
So, Charles, you talk about this offense, this week 8 of the 2021 campaign. Now, normally this would be the halfway point of the season, but as we all know, this is now a 17-game regular season. And because of that, it seems like now maybe more than ever, getting your open week to occur later in the season, that could be a pretty big advantage.
Brandon, it's always been a big advantage, and now, as you pointed out, the possibility of it becoming huge, likely. Most teams want that late open date. Because of injuries, you know, getting that rest before the playoff push, all of those things. Sometimes when you get an open date early in the season, it's not very much of an advantage. You might be playing well, not slows down your momentum. This is a big deal, and teams definitely like it. The later, the better.
Watch the backer. Chippity four! Crunch!
the punt team sending this one away. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Rams will be backed up deep to begin the drive as they take over first and 10. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown. Now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. Looking to throw, Perkins. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. On first down, Perkins. Right side complete. That's Woods. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Just a yard to go here on second down. They'll run out of the gun with Akers. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. From the gun, Perkins. That's out to the flat for Akers. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Second and six. No, scratch that. Second and seven. To throw, Perkins. Here's a diving catch right side.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar. You
circle the Pro Bowl.
Without a doubt, that's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. That's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Second down, they'll go with Akers again. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here, third and five.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Normally on third down and short yardage, you're thinking to throw to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field, and a nice dart picks up the first down and then some.
Throwing on first down, Perkins. And that is incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Here's second and 10. Again, running right is Akers. Trucks over him. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line.
Boy, this is a well-orchestrated drive they've put together. You think back to how far they were backed up to start things out. But they've gone on a march since then, and now after that completion there, they've got a first and goal.
They'll look to run with Akers. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the one.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown, far today. He's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
Second and goal from the one. Akers again, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Cam Akers with his second touchdown of the game, number 8 on the season. And the Rams have taken the lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up 2 straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they can get this game tied up.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there in his second and 11.
Check, back 42. Watch the slam. Let him go.
Here's Watson.
Check, 42 is the mark.
And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Mike 42,
you ain't doing nothing today. You ain't doing nothing today.
42's Mike, 42's Mike.
That's right.
Throwing on third down, Watson. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they fell behind early, but since then, 2 touchdowns and a 14-7 lead.
Yeah, they found the end zone on their first 2 drives, and even more so after the defense gave up the first lead. With these last 2 drives, obviously they inspired their D because they shut them down the last time out. They hope to continue that string.
To throw on second down, Perkins flush to his right, and he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down.
One thing you hope to see out of a rookie tight end is a real concentration when the ball's in the air, and I'm not sure that he didn't. But he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. The Rams on third down, a perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and 11. Open man right side is Kupp, complete. And they'll get him down at about the 37, well short of the first. So on fourth down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. He gets this away. It's a good one, drawing toward the sidelines. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line. Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trade expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards. second and three, second and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10. From the gun, here's Watson. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Hawkins. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Now a first down throw, Watson. Now he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 29, and he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. So this is something we didn't see at all from this offense in the victory last week. That's a turnover. They didn't have any, but giving the ball away here in the opening quarter.
I love the surprise in your voice because it's exactly what you stated. Didn't see it last week, but it's a key to their win. And it'll be a key to this game as well. Protecting the football. Didn't get it done there.
And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. Looking to throw. Perkins. Trying to find Cup, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Jimmy Moreland. And he will not get all the way home, but he will take this back down to about the 2-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise.
And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. A great play there with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Texans are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half. Fairbairn good with the extra point, and we are tied here in the second quarter. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And with a little under a minute to play, they may be looking to pick up some yardage here, maybe try and come up with a field goal to seize the lead before intermission. The ball comes out, and the Texans say they have it. They do. And they will bring this one back.
Oh, I know how to
return for the Texans touchdown. And Charles, look at the big fella. What a rumble that was. Not only to scoop it, but then take it the rest of the way for the touchdown.
And now you know they're going to have to hear about it from now on. The defensive backs, he's going to want to run with them, do their drills, the whole deal. He thinks he's the pace setter now.
It doesn't matter what happens in practice this week, he's smiling. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And the lead is now 21-14. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. No return here for Calais, and this will be a touchback. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And with them trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together, maybe get the field goal range. And an anxious moment or two there, but they do get him down. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second, as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number 2. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Back to throw, Perkins. Under pressure, and the Texans able to get in there for the sack. Jonathan Grenard. He's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. Going up top for Cup. And that will be incomplete. to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. The Rams set to receive the second half kickoff, and they trail here as we resume play. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they trail here to begin the second half. What's going to be a key for them to get back in the game?
I think they're right there, and I think this game is still up for the taking for them because we always talk about turnovers. They had two of them in the first half, and once you start talking about if you have three, four, or five, you know it's beyond difficult to try and win a football game with that. Those have to be eliminated. If they take care of the ball, they still got a shot.
Escaping the pressure right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that. And they force another incompletion.
And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. So from the 36 now, first and 10. On the handoff for Takers. He's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up. Found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Flushed out right. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for 3rd.
Let's go. 70 Lions.
They'll try and run for this with Akers. And he's got enough for the first to cross midfield to the 48.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
It's a jet sweep, the football to Woods. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Tackled by the corner, C.J. Henderson. Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, the funny things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion, and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. A loss on that play, and now 3rd down gets tougher, 3rd and 6.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
And he's going to be taken down with another 1st down as the stop's made at the Texans 28.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up the 1st down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover it before he gets going?
Steps away to his left. And it's intercepted. Picked up by Justin Reed. And the Texans force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. And their defense just helped him out by getting the football back on the open drive here in the second half. And now can the offense follow through with points on their first possession?
And that's a big one for them because after the work the defense has done, they've got a chance here to open up this lead.
That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on 1st down. A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on 2nd and 13. Watson off play action. He's letting it fly for Cooks. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down.
I like the fact that he took the shot deep downfield. Even if you don't get the catch, maybe you get a defensive penalty and pick up the yardage that way.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. short. And that leads to a fourth down. On is the punter, Johnston, now as he sends this one away. And this punt will go out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25, and it will. Right at the 24-yard line is where they'll spot it. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, I think it matters in part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know what, a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10.
Watch the run, watch the run.
Perkins' throw pulled in by Woods. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans 23. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Buying time to his left. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and that'll be second down. Looking to throw. Perkins. He's got it. It's Higbee. Touchdown, Rams. Tyler Higbee, his first touchdown on the year. And the Rams have a chance to tie the ball game here in the final minute of the third. Here's Gay now to add the extra point. He's got it, and we're all tied at 21. Couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he'll
Let's
just
go.
Take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. Hands it off out of the gun. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Here's second and a yard. Keep it on the ground. It's Hawkins. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we played three quarters. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Texans on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This time they face a third and 2. Nifty move. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 44 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game. I tell you, they didn't give it to him much for the first three quarters, but when they have, he's been efficient. Maybe they ride him more here down the stretch.
Yeah, not sure it was actually in the game plan for him to have as few carries as he has, but it might play out really well for them now. As you noted, they want to ride him down the stretch. He should have fresh legs.
And he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down.
That's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It's only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
On second down now, it's Hawkins. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
They've got tight left, 4 down.
he throws there incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
Hey, we heavy on the edges, heavy on the edges. 49!
Hey, alert!
Faking the give. Now Watson. And that is incomplete.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one. Closed quickly. And he'll force the incompletion.
They will look for some important yardage on third down. From here, it would be a 60-yard boot.
Here we go. 50-50. Mike 50.
Watson now to throw. This is complete to Hawkins. He is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
Well, they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
And they'll try the jet sweep here. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Let's go, D. It's going to be a long day, offense. It's going to be a long day.
Rush in.
Shine him up.
Off of play action, it's Watson. That's going to be caught. And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. Donovan Peoples-Jones, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Texans answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the fourth. Fairbairn good with the extra point, and they will take a seven-point lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And now after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a seven-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I know a coach told me before, he always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame, get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game. Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork, and add in a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
On first and 10. Perkins, eluding the pressure. teams as he'll get him down shy of the 20. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. We'll see if they can band back together after the pick six. It hurt badly, but still within striking distance. A two-score game with a good chunk of time on the clock. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into his windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
He had no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Operating from the gun, Perkins. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. And he's got his target, Harris. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
Off the play fake, Perkins. This is caught, it's Woods. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Working the sideline there, good route, good catch, first down, and he gets out of bounds.
Yeah, you have to like the play call, because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down. From the gun, Perkins. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off at the 15, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Boy, so another interception, CD. It feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
I'm coming for you, son. Switch.
Alert, alert.
Check 52.
They'll keep it on the ground. Hawkins. And he'll be taken down here at about the 23-yard line. They had 3 yards on first down, just 1 yard there. Just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Reset.
19.
Check.
And go.
And they take a knee. So Houston going to come away here with the victory. And they were spurred on by a strong performance in that fourth quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game, but when you throw one in the fourth quarter, that tells everyone that you're getting stronger and dominance is starting to take over, right? The from the time you're playing Little League.